Bill.
On this Veterans Day, joining us are James Miller with the Center for Wish from the Hudson Institute. Thanks for joining us, gentlemen.
Pleasure.
Here to focus on the defense policy proposals of the Obama administration, primarily defense, also on Veterans Affairs. The election is over, but the issue of Iraq is not, obviously. The report this morning in the New York Times and other newspapers about the bombing yesterday in Baghdad, a synchronized triple bombing in northern Baghdad. And in this story about the bombing yesterday, which killed 28 in Baghdad, they also write that Monday negotiations continued between Iraq and the United States over a long-term security agreement. Iraq spokesman said changes proposed by the United States last week were not enough, and his government had asked Washington for revisions it wanted. This is reported by the Associated Press. This is this so-called status of forces agreement.
Right.
Why is this important for the incoming Obama administration?
Bill, it's essential for the incoming administration and indeed for the country because it specifies the circumstances under which U.S. forces operate and the degree to which they're accountable to Iraqi law while they're deployed in Iraq. The issue has been a question of the timeline for withdrawal. The Iraqis want withdrawal by the end of 2011, and the Bush administration has resisted that to date. And so that's got to be worked out, and along with any flexibility associated with that. And then a question of the degree to which Americans come under Iraqi law versus our own uniform code of military justice.
Is it your thought that this will be worked out before, it has to be worked out, I guess, before President Bush leaves, correct?
I don't think it has to be absolutely signed and delivered before President Bush leaves, but I think there's certainly going to be a strong effort to get it that far. It's a very difficult agreement because the United States has effectively attempted to portray itself as neutral in this region through its status of forces negotiations, and there are lots of people in the region who, in fact, do not want us to appear neutral. The Saudis, for example, other members of the other Gulf states, because they fear the possibility of the Americans allowing or turning a blind eye toward Iranian influence in the region.
What has President-elect Obama proposed specifically about forces in Iraq?
Senator Obama has proposed withdrawing U.S. forces, combat forces, over a period of about 16 months after he takes office. That, in fact, is not very different from the timeline that's being negotiated now with withdrawal by the end of 2011. As Ender suggested, the key political issue that's making it difficult in Iraq now is the provincial elections in January. It's a tough time to get a negotiated agreement, and at this point, it may be more likely to have a rollover of the U.N. Security Council resolution. And then the Obama administration would be responsible for negotiating the SOFA.
When you say a rollover, what does that mean practically?
It means going back to the United Nations, getting an agreement that U.S. forces will stay in Iraq for perhaps a period of 6 months to a year. And during that period and after the Iraqi provincial elections, then negotiating the terms of the SOFA, the Status of Forces Agreement.
Let's make sure our callers know the numbers to call in, 202-737-0002 for Republicans. 202-737-0001 for, 0002 for Democrats, 0001 for Republicans, and 202-628-0205 for Independents and all others. Our guests, Enders Wimbush and James Miller. Enders Wimbush, you're with the Hudson Institute. You're with the Center for the New American Security. What's the Hudson Institute's interest in defense policy?
We have a long-standing interest in defense policy. Hudson Institute was created by the great futurist Herman Kahn, going back to the doomsday machine and thinking the unthinkable. So we have had a long legacy in defense and security issues. That has continued up right to the present day. We tend to focus on long-term security. The Hudson Institute's general view is out over the horizon. We are not futurists, but we tend to try to think about security landscapes that are perhaps 20, maybe 25 or 35 years in the future.
Is there an issue that the Obama team has not thought of yet that you, in terms of defense, that you'd like them to focus on?
The campaign generally, Bill, has been, in my view, very thin on foreign policy. Some of us had hoped that Senator McCain, for example, would give a very profound, deep, textured foreign policy speech, but he never really did. In particular, what was left out of most of the discussion in the campaign was how the various candidates were going to treat Asia. Look, we're tied up in the Middle East. The Middle East is where most of our attention is. Afghanistan comes in for its share, but the reality is that the United States is going to be most heavily engaged in Asia for the next 15 to 25 or 30 years.
Are you talking specifically like the Georgia conflict that came up, or just
broadly? No, I'm thinking more broadly. I think there are a number of dynamics that are at work. You've got a rising China, whose growth will have to be managed. And I say that not in the sense of that it has to be contained. It will have to be managed. And that certainly is the subtext of every conversation you have with everybody in the region, from Japan to Australia to India to the Gulf.
Jim Miller, I'll ask you the same question. The Center for a New American Security, fairly new organization?
It is indeed.
And your focus is?
Our focus is on national security and defense policy. We're just about 2 years old, founded by Kurt Campbell and Michelle Flournoy, our CEO and president. Our mission is to bring bipartisan approaches to hard security problems.
And if there's an issue, same thing, that the campaign, specifically the Obama administration, the incoming administration, hasn't focused on, what would you say it is?
I think that the campaign and the incoming administration has probably looked at a lot of issues. I agree with Enders that the question of Asia is important. And the place where they're going to probably have to spend more time than they have in discussion so far, in addition to that, is Russia.
I want to get both of your reaction before we get to calls. The story this morning, and this has been reported in a number of places here in the Wall Street Journal, Obama leans towards asking Gates to remain at Pentagon for another year. Good idea or bad idea?
Well, I think it's a good idea to have him remain for perhaps another year. It's not clear to me that he wants to remain, and I think that's the big discussion around town. That said, there are a number of very capable candidates being mentioned. Richard Danzig, former Secretary of the Navy, John Hamry, now leading CSIS, who came out of the Pentagon, and others. Very, very capable. I think that almost everybody would find considerable comfort with them.
James Miller, your thoughts on Robert Gates remaining on for continuity? Good idea? Or?
He's been nonpartisan. He's been a terrific public servant, and there's a very good reason that the Obama administration would consider keeping him on. There are, and I agree, however, that there are strong candidates, including Richard Danzig from the Democratic side. The issue that will have to be dealt with by the administration if he does stay on, perhaps the biggest one, is this next quadrennial defense review. Every 4 years, Congress mandates a top-to-bottom review of the defense program and priorities, starting from strategy on down through the allocation of resources. And if you stay in for a short period of time, will it be Secretary Gates' review, or will it be President Obama's review? They probably need to understand up front the degree to which they're in agreement on the big issues before Secretary Gates
would
agree to stay on.
Why is that QDR, that quadrennial defense review, so important?
This administration is inheriting perhaps the most challenging security environment, with two ongoing wars, and plus in Iraq and Afghanistan, the war on terror, the other challenges around the world, including Iran and Pakistan. And it's got to balance between operations today and long-term investments to deal with issues like cybersecurity and space. It's very challenging in the context of a recession, and the defense budget will have a lot of pressures on it. So one of the most daunting inheritances in the quadrennial defense review is this administration's big chance to put its stamp on defense policy.
Let's hear from our